So the car was like swerving, so she was just like crying. Then in my mind, I'm like, come, what if we are driving trailer? I don't get it. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. New year, I'm Omotayo, a lifestyle content creator here in Lagos, Nigeria. Please consider subscribing and join the family because it's the family of God. Yes. Please consider subscribing and join the family. Thank you. Thank you. So today guys, I'm going to be sharing with you my experience with driving. Yes, I finally, if you guys remember the video on, I think it was resolution or stuff that I have planned for this year. So yes guys, I finally learned driving, and okay, I'm just going to be sharing my first day experience. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it. You guys, of course, like normal learners, like somebody that wants to learn, just the same way maybe the first time of starting YouTube, you like when you want to start something new, sort of, it's always the first time, right? And you're always excited, like during your first time, that oh, I can't wait, that kind of feeling. So I was really excited, the energy was high, you get me, the energy was high. On that first day, mind, I'm like, okay, it's going to be fun. I'm going to learn something new and all that stuff. Eventually, so I listed as what made it not fun on that very first day. Seriously, like it was below my expectation. I should not lie, because I'm this kind of person. I get excited about new things. So first of all, guys, see what happened to tolulope solutions happened to me.
So I know some of you actually entered here. Like you came inside, you walk inside this place because of solutions. Yes, we are welcome to the show. Please join the family if you are led to. Okay, yeah, I'm a proud part of some solutions too. Yes, so we gathered the. Actually, I've wanted to make this video for a while now, but when I saw it on our
high jeep story,
I'm like, wow. So I'm not the only one. But then I couldn't like save it, so I just missed it. So later when I now did the video, the day I actually recorded this video again, I think I now saw a post again just come up, like she is after like putting it up on the status, she TikTok or something, she now uploaded it on her feed, on her reels, I think, again. I'm like, ah, this is a confirmation that God want me to do this video, so let's fire on. So hey guys, I'm going to play the video for you and sit back and enjoy.
Hi guys, so I'm just here to ask you guys a question, like really simple, and it's that, why are fitness instructors always shouting? Don't shout at me. Don't tell me 3 more hours to go, you can do this. No, if I can't do it, I can't do it. Don't be shouting at me. I'm a grown woman, somebody's mother, married woman for that matter. Don't add to my mental pressure. I know I want to lose weight. Shouting, don't give up now, shut up.
She was just parrying, like she was pissed. Obviously, it's definitely not only her it has happened to. I think it's kind of general, I don't know. But I mean, so this is my point. That first day was very crazy. Like, I left the house, right? I was excited when I got there. I'm like, so when I got there, I registered. I paid deposit. I paid for the deposit before starting. So basically, they first taught me theory, like signs and symbols. Is that what I would call them? Signs, yeah, like road signs and all that. It was kind of really brief, but they just showed me and taught me. So it was like later on that I got to learn better on the signs, the road signs and all of that and all those stuffs. After that time, so after the theory part, so I got into the car. So then the driving classes took like roughly 30 to 1 hour. It wasn't even up to 1 hour sharp, but each session I go for took like 30 to 1 hour max, and 1 hour like covering everything. And then when it was time to start the driving, the instructor, hey guys, I've not heard this part before, but from what the local solutions displayed, I knew that okay, it was real. I mean, I had a taste of it that day. It was crazy. Are those instructors always this annoying, like very annoying? So this guy, Ubushu, just listen to me. I learned automatic. So basically, this driving stuff, I've had to undo cars before that particular day, which is my brother was taking me with manual car before, but it wasn't for like a long time. because majority of what he taught me about the manner, I've actually forgotten. For the automatic, sometimes ago also, my husband has been taking me. I've had to handle a car basically before, he gets both manual and automatic, but I add up all the saying I have handled car before, it's not even up to 2 days at stretch. The reason why I put that out there is to say that basically when you are trying to learn to drive, the first thing is fear of being on the road and facing cars, or being in the middle of the road having so many cars, trailers and all this downfall and a lot of, you know, here and there. So first of all, that one was out of it. I was kind of confident on the road to some extent, so I wasn't really scared of the road like that. So what was in for me, will I be able to learn it within this number of days, or will I be able to balance well? Because I know that has always been my issue, balancing, like will I know when to turn or like that. So eventually, that's how this instructor, the first guy that taught me, I first noticed it. So always beating them, like he's trying to correct them, right? Like they are trying to drive the steering, you're not beating their hand. They are saying ways to correct people, not like yelling or beating. I wouldn't even call it tapping, because that's not tapping, that's like ungrab me, as in they are beating. It's really crazy for me. It's just not it, because for somebody that is not confident enough on the roads, for somebody that I'm still struggling with the fear of on the road, you're now adding yelling or you're adding beating to it. I know that was just a turn off for me. I'm like, what's going on? I paid my money for F's sake. Are you normal? Excuse me, young man, what's going on here? So I've been noticing him doing that for people before me. So I felt like maybe he's not going to do it to me. Maybe because they are used to, you know, the way they learn or something. But even me, that he hasn't done it for me, but doing it, seeing him doing it to somebody else was already pissing me off. Like, what's up? Like, what's up? Eventually, it was my turn. I got there, but you're trying to correct me with something, and you're shouting or you're beating me. If I'm scared of the road, it's something that I can easily lose balance or lose focus or not even get whatever you're trying to teach me, even though eventually I didn't even understand whatever he's trying to correct me for. Anyways, you guys, it was not funny. You should just listen to this part. I was just like, so when he started doing it for me, I'm like, why are you beating me? I don't like it. Do I look like a secondary school girl for you? Or do I look like, I don't know what I'm doing? Or do I look like a baby to you? That's what I even told him. I was like, do I look like a baby to you? I've been watching you do it to others. If you can, it was like, are you the first person that I'm going to train? Are you the first person that will learn from me? Are you the first person I've been beating? I said, Oga, I'm not the first person. Absolutely, yes. But we are not the same people. If you can beat them and they are okay with it, I am not okay with beating. Do not, if you want to correct me, please correct me very well, like a sane person. Correct me reasonably. Not that you'll be beating me, shouting at me. Did I not pay my money? I said, do I not know the reason why I came to driving school? There are people that can teach me driving without coming to driving school. Besides, what's the big deal? I pay my money. Why would you be shouting at somebody even if I didn't pay you? So like, if you are doing the service for free, you will be banging me. You'll just be banging my head. I don't get it. I was like, what if I'm going to school? I say, God, I don't know. Let me not talk too much. Sincerely, it was just annoying. What if maybe they are teaching me in school? I said, so in your own school, they used to beat them. Like, do I look like kindergarten to you? You are telling me about school. Does this place look like school? Do you know what you are saying? Are you normal? I just say, Oga, don't beat me. That's just what I know. Don't beat me. Otherwise, I'm going to stop this car. I'm not going again. It's not by force. So it was not like. It was hugging, it was like back and forth, you get. I was driving, you guys, it was not funny. That's how, as in, I was sincerely, I was just very annoyed, because he was not listening to me at first. He was still doing this thing. And he kept doing the same thing I said you should stop doing. So, I don't know how to explain it, but the car, you know, I was just hungry. I was like, see, because I'm just learning, I don't know how to balance yet, you get. So the car was like swerving left and right, swerving. The people at the back, like people that, you know, it's turn by turn. People that are going to, like, for example, when I lived there, the other person that is going to come after me and take that place was just like, see, please calm down, please, YouTube people should just calm down, please, don't worry, just listen to him. YouTube, stop beating. Even that lady was like, bros, please don't beat me in my own time. Like, just so you know that it's actually pissing. You guys, it was not funny. And it was funny, but it was not funny. Now, in all of this, yes, before you start saying it's not good because of the road, blah, blah, blah. Let me tell you, in all of this, I was not bothered. Let me tell you why. Just know why. Keep watching. Okay. Because I'm not telling you yet. Okay. I don't know if I say it, but really, in all of this, I wasn't bothered because I know majorly all this driving school, as you are pressing brake where you are, they're actually pressing the brake for you right beside you. Like, the instructor will be pressing brake, because I mean, it's not everybody that knows how to do it here, so they can't just leave you by yourself. Unlike the normal car that doesn't have, there's a way they work those things. They already work brake in the other side, for the instructor side. So I guess the person at the back, the lady at the back, is not aware of it. You get? So she was panicking, like, ha. See, okay, it's not funny, but it's funny, sincerely. But at that moment, I was really very angry, sincerely, because it was just annoying. You're teaching me and you're acting like that. I mean, if I don't have confidence on the road already, I don't know. Eventually, when it was, like, the way I said, it was going back and forth, like, the car was swerving. Not really that bad, you get. But because I couldn't balance, you get, it was swerving. But I know it's pressing the brake, so I didn't bother. I was not bothered. Like, I was not bothered. I was just trying to drive my point home that, what's up? Like, are you fine? Are you okay? What's going on? So it was just the lady at the back that was trying to, like, panicking and all that. I was just smiling in my mind that this lady doesn't know. You don't know what's going on. I mean, there's brake right there, okay? Nobody wants to lose their life. I mean, I also love my life. So that was just it, Sha. And so I had to stop talking. I stopped talking to him, and I stopped answering him. I didn't say anything again, because I've said what I want to say. So it's left to you to listen or not. So everything was saying next, maybe what if you pay your money, call. Like, if you don't know how to drive now, it's your fault. If you can't drive now, it's your fault, because you're not listening. Because you're saying they should not beat you. If they don't beat somebody, how will somebody learn? Can you even imagine? I don't know which word to use. That mentality is so... Let me just calm down, because I'm vexed. No, but really, that mentality is just out of it. It's just, for me, as far as I'm concerned, let me just wrap it up in a local mentality. I mean, how would you even say that? It's just a typical African or Nigerian mentality, like, everything has to be kakaran, kankankan, before you're able to drive with your point. Like, if you don't beat somebody, the person will not learn. Or if you don't shout, the person will not understand. No, it doesn't work that way. Besides, you're not dealing with babies. I was just like, I was not answering him again. He was talking everything back and forth. He said, if I don't learn it, it's my fault. It's not his fault. And it's not the driving school fault. Blah, blah, blah. I was even saying, no problem. Your driving school might be okay. But you as a person, you are even tarnishing their image. So I was like, last, I will not tell people. I will not refer people. Say, I should not refer. Like, it was even... See, all of it, to me, I just feel like it's power intoxicates, as far as I'm concerned. And local mentality jammed together equals to nonsensical rubbish. That's what it's doing him. But so, I didn't bother answering again. Everything was saying, I just kept mute. I was just, like, doing what I was doing, because I know what I wanted to do in my mind. I didn't say anything. It was not like... And there's something they do. Like, there's something they do. They'll say... They'll say... Your side, my side, your side, my side. What's your side? What's my side? See, this, I don't know. This, it was a totally new experience, actually. But it was fun at the end of the day, you get. But those are just the bad side of it. But it was just fun. Your side, my side. So it started saying that, your side, my side. Your side, my side means maybe his side is like the left, the right, you get. So saying that, turn to the right. Like, you know, right, trying to help me to balance. So if it's my side, that's left side. If it's his side, that's right side. It took me time to understand that also. Like, I was just trying to understand a lot of things myself, you guys. And you're still putting me under unnecessary pressure of shouting and yelling because you want to drive home. a point that you can easily say it in a very mature way. Anyways, he kept saying, your side, my side, your side, my side. You know what that means? Because I've talked that, I don't like the way he beats me. I mean, you can't use... What are you telling me? I understand how it works psychologically, you get me? So even before he started doing that, I already know that that's what he's going to do. So because I've talked, so he will start doing as if whether he like or not, that kind of attitude. It was, as he was saying, your side, my side, I said, see, continue. If you like saying my side, your side. That was what I said. I was in my mind, I'm like, come, what if you are driving trailer? I don't get it. Like, because, I mean, you know the African mentality. See, people are just funny. This is what I see. People like that are the people that, you know what they say, power intoxicates. No, because they are placed, they are in the position of, they are training you or they are teaching you, whether or not you pay for service, naturally, it has, I don't know if it's a Nigerian thing or it's just human generally. I know that everybody is not the same like that, but majority of people are, like, once they give you one small power, you start want to be misusing it or whatever. That's where I see it, because you are training, you are training. If you are now professor on call, like, I don't get it. So number two was about the car. I don't get it. Okay, maybe because I wanted a place that is closer to me, so I just got, it wasn't like anywhere like that. Because it was mainly closer to me, I felt like, okay, let me just do with this. Plus I had someone that has learned there before. I know that it's not going to be like all driving schools that does this. You get, some of them have good cars, but majority of them, maybe, I don't know which area, or I don't know, but majority of them, the car was also like, it wasn't good. I don't know if it's technical, they call it or whatever, but you get, I don't know what that is in English, but it was not working so well. Yes, it wasn't working so well. It was slow, you get. Then the steering was kind of hard. I mean, I know that it, for a normal sane car, the steering will not be that hard. You know the way it is now, because it's a driving school, so people, maybe even the instructors, we tend to want to drive the car the way they like, you get. So it can't be posh, all poshy, the way I'm thinking it to be, like a private car. No, it can't be like that. So that was the first turn off for me, like, what kind of car is this one? Like, I mean, how is somebody using this kind of car to learn? It was like a big no for me. They repaired it eventually along the line, but that first day was just, I'm just telling you raw how it happened. And the greatest turn off for me on this car issue was fuel. Like, how on earth will fuel finish in the car? How? No, I'm not saying that fuel can finish in the car, you get me? But for me, I believe that anything can be wrong with the car, but it shouldn't be fuel for me. Because, I mean, why is the fuel gauge there? But, you know, because of the normal Nigerian kind of mentality, maybe. I used to say that if anything will be faulty in the car, if anything will be wrong with the car, it shouldn't be fuel, because it's something that we can control. So, for that, it was a turn off for me. Okay, yes, those are the little stuff that was already a turn off for me at the beginning.